Hi, welcome back down to my basement. It's Dan Veall here once again, and this is the Spector NS2 CTB. As you can see already, it is a fretless bass guitar. Let's get up to the headstock end and we'll work all the way down the instrument in detail. So up top, signature Spector headstock. You'll probably know this well by now. Lightweight tuning keys. Let's flip the bass over. Let's have a little look at those. There we go. Nicely installed there, nice and even. And Stuart Spector's information as he imprinted on the back of the headstock there. So signature, model number, and date it was made. Fantastic. Spinning over, oh, this is a maple neck, by the way. So a nice bit of maple there. Flip it over, like so. And we have on the front of the headstock here, I'm gonna spin it around so the camera can see it a bit better. We have a ebony veneer here. Brass nut, okay. And then we go down onto a PAL ferro fretboard. For a moment, I nearly said rosewood there, but it's not. Okay, flat round strings on here. And look at this lovely naked neck. You just see a lovely, lovely wood grain there. No dots, no nothing. And then if I just flip the bass forward a little bit, dots on the top of the neck so you can see where you are on a darkened stage. For those who find fretless bass a little bit scary, i.e. me, I wouldn't say that I was a brilliant fretless player, and I would dearly love to spend more time with a fretless. So Stuart Spector, if you'd like to send me a fretless bass, this is very nice. Okay, so anyway, moving on. Up the neck, let's go onto the body. This is the NS2 shape. So it's, you know, it's the famous kind of Spector shape, which I really like actually. It's downsized, it's super comfortable, but this is a little bit different. So let's have a look at this. The top is a reclaimed Ridwood top, and it's shaped, it's carved, has a beautiful shape to it. In fact, what I'm gonna do is I wanna flip the bass upwards so you can actually see, so I suppose horizontally, what that looks like. Hopefully if I can just spin that a little bit, then you'll see that against the camera. So, and you can actually see that it's a little bit different. I mean, kind of like the body's got a shape to it, the top's got a shape to it, and actually the way that the strings come up to meet the bridge, it's a much steeper angle than you would get on, say, like a normal electric. And as I roll it back forwards again, you also see that it is a chambered body. The chamber itself, the body wood is older. So I'm gonna flip the bass over. I'm gonna have a look at the back, and you'll see, as we just roll it over, you'll see the top, like so. And we have this really nice honey burst finish. I also really, really like it because it's a satin finish, so instead of being really, really glossy. You know, don't get me wrong, I love my glossy finishes, but this just looks super nice. Battery compartment. Compartment for obviously all the electronics and the like out the way. Bolt on neck. Really, really nice and tidy. And I love this. Look at this lovely cutaway here. So you can get right up into the upper regions of the fretboard for a lovely solo playing. Flipping the bass back over again. Okay, and we get on to the electronic side of things. So we have on board DCB pickups. I really like these, actually. The DCB rails are just really, really nice pickups. I've got some in one of my other basses, and I've liked these, dead silent, and have a nice kind of breadth of tone to them. But not only have we got one normal sort of magnetic pickup under here, we've also got a Fishman kind of like sensor unit, a piezo unit in there, sat on a really tasteful bridge. Strings come over the top, and then we've got anchors around the back as well. I'm gonna spin that around for the camera, so hopefully you can see that, like that. And strings are anchored in, like so. Now, the instrument itself being chambered and hollow, it's ridiculously light. The other thing I didn't mention earlier on is also, it can be considered a short scale. 30 3/8 inch scale. It doesn't feel it though. I have to say that its bass doesn't feel like a short scale bass at all. Some, they do feel squat, but this one still balances really, really nicely. And I don't feel that I'm playing something which is like freakishly small comparisoned to say my Dingwall basses that have a 37 inch scale to them, which you know, are beasts in some people's hands. Okay, anyway, tonally, we have, as I said, the Fishman piezo pickup, Aguilar's DCB. The whole lot is tied to a OBP3 circuit from Aguilar as well, stacked bass and treble. We also have a separate mid control here as well for boost and cut, and also a pull switch, which allows us to shift that mid frequency. Finally, a volume and a volume for each of the pickups. Now, what I'm going to do is, even though there's only like a few controls here, the sounds that we can coax from this are crazy. I could be here all day. So what I want to do is I'm going to buzz through the settings, but you really need to get hold of one of these to play through and listen to yourself, because it's something that you'll find an immense amount of tones in there. I like it. I really do. Okay, so first of all, let's have a listen to each of the pickups in turn. So if I wind back the DCB and turn up the volume of the bridge pickup here, then this is what the bass sounds like, piezo alone. Okay, here we go. Very nice. Okay, switching around. All I'm going to do is I'm going to buzz around and do pretty much the same thing on the other pickup. So this is the DCB on its own. I've turned down the piezo element. Okay, here we go. A different character. I hope that you can hear that. Again, I know I bang on about this, but decent earphones, please. No laptop speakers. You want to listen to this in really nice audio to hear the best of this instrument. Okay, let's have a look at the EQ. What I'm going to do is I'm going to wind both pickups on. So we've got a mixture of the two. Let's have a little listen to that. And then I'm going to sweep through some equalizer settings. Okay, here we go. Okay, so mid control, as I said, it's got two specific settings for frequencies, and I'm going to just do both of those very, very quickly. So here is some mid boost, and this is the lower frequency setting. Mid cut. By cutting out those mids, I can hear some more subs coming in from below. That actually adds a real warmth to the instrument. Okay, so let's go back the other way, and I'm going to switch the pull switch upwards, and we'll have a different center frequency for those mids. And then scooping out those upper mids. So the character really goes from that, you know, people talk about fretless basses having that moah sort of a character to it. And by boosting those mids, you're getting that by the absolute spade load. Cutting that out, and for me, it starts going to that more, the warmth and pillowy bottom end of a double bass. So finding that sweet spot is going to be really, really useful, I think, depending on which character you want the most. Bass and treble, fairly simple affair, really. The OBP3 circuit is just a brilliant classic circuit. Lots and lots of depth to the low end, and a nice, almost like shimmer, pick attack to the treble frequencies. So let's just boost the low to begin with. I'm back with both pickups on, so boosting the lows. There's a lot of boost there. I haven't turned it all the way up. And then cutting it away, I think this is going to take away a fair amount of like weight or girth from the tone, simply because it's such a broad low end. Okay, let's have a little listen. Indeed, so yeah, I'd watch that carefully. I wouldn't want to pull too much of that low end away. We still kind of get the woodiness of the instrument, but maybe just too much weight is taken off. Maybe you just start losing yourself against other musicians, possibly. Okay, so top end, this is top end boost. It adds that, you know, sort of clack, that sort of top end, which boosting it too much maybe could be a bit harsh through certain systems. I think I'd probably like to round that off a little bit to get some of that almost antique warmth in, if you see what I'm saying. So let's do that. Let's pull the treble control back. Yeah, nice, kind of like pillowy, sort of just like lifts the low end. I think it would drop in a mix really, really nicely against other acoustic instruments, for example. Okay, lovely, brilliant. Hopefully you've got a good idea about the kind of sounds that we can get from the instrument. I could certainly sit here and play all day and certainly improve my questionable fretless technique, but that said, I've really thoroughly enjoyed playing this, and I think if I had one of these, I would probably spend most of my time zooming around it and creating some cool fretless tones and sounds. Brilliant stuff, excellent. So more information going in the written review. But for now, thanks for checking this out with me. This is the Spector NS2 CTB bass.